Hi guys, this is Sushant, Kochar, and today we are going to talk about how is intermittent fasting done? What are the types of intermittent fasting with which we can do intermittent fasting? See, there can be two types of intermittent fasting in categories. There can be two categories. So one is where you are eating some food in your whole day, which is known as time-restricted fasting. And the another one is when you do not eat anything in your whole day, which is known as whole day fasting. First we'll talk about the one where you eat something in your whole day, time restricted fasting. So one of the most famous methods is 16:8, so where you will not, out of the 24 hours in the day, you will not eat anything for 16 hours and you'll eat your food in 8-hour window, 8-hour time frame. For the fasting time of 16 hours, you can pick any time frame of the day, but it is highly advisable that you pick a time frame that covers the night time, because you would be sleeping for 7, 8 or 9 hours, and it is less likely that you are going to be breaking your fast because you will feel less hunger while sleeping. If you are awake for the whole 16 hours fasting window, then you will feel a lot of hunger. It is more likely that you will break your fast before the 16 hours end. So it is better that you cover your 16 hour fasting window over the night time when you are sleeping. And also in the holy spiritual texts, it has been said that eating at night is harmful for health in many ways. So if you keep your fasting window after sunset till sunrise, then you save yourself from those harmful effects of eating at night also. So basically, an example can be that your first meal starts at 9 a.m. in the morning and your last meal ends around 5 p.m. in the evening. Now, if you shorten the time frame of this fasting window, then you can fast for 12 hours and then you can eat in the 12-hour window, which is a more lenient method of 16:8. Now, this can be thought of as Ratri Bhojan Tyag, where we do not eat at night. So, although you can keep the 12-hour fasting window at any time, but it is similar to what our ancestors used to do in Ratri Bhojan Tyag, where they would not eat at night. So after sunset around 6 or 7 p.m. Till sunrise around 6 or 7 a.m. They'll not be eating for about 12 hours and they'll eat for the rest of 12 hours. But it is advisable that you keep your fasting window to more than 12 hours, for like 13, 14, 15, 16 hours, maybe 17 or 18 hours, because the bigger the fasting window, the better it is. And if you take your fasting window to really high level, like 23 hours of fasting and just 1 hour of eating, then it becomes to what our ancestors used to call ekasana, where they would just sit down for once in the whole day and eat whatever they can in one sitting, and they'll not eat again for that day. So that is equivalent to this, where you eat in around 40-45 minutes of time frame, within 1 hour of time frame, and you do not eat for rest of the 23 hours in the day. And then this one is AM fasting, where after you wake up at 6, 7, 8, 9 in the morning, you do not eat anything till 12 noon. Now, these were when you eat in your whole day. Now, the second one, second category is where you do not eat in your whole day. So, the first one is upvas. We call it upvas in Hindi. That is whole day fast. You do not eat anything in your whole day. Now, you can do it 6:1. So, for one day in a week, you do not eat anything, and for the rest of the 6 days, in the week, you eat something. You can eat your food. You can do it 5:2. For 2 days, you don't eat anything, and 5 days, you eat your food in the whole week. And you can keep these 2 days a bit distant. So maybe not necessarily consecutive, because you might feel a bit more weak. That is your call. Now, ekantar, this is what we call it in Hindi, which is alternate day fasting. So, you eat one day and you don't eat the next day, then you again eat the third day, then you don't eat the fourth day, and you keep doing that. So, all of these, if you observe them, all of these are what you might have heard and seen from your ancestors, your grandmother, grandfather, and their parents. So this is, all of these are part of tapasya, that we call it in Hindi, where we kind of reduce our intake of food or eliminate our intake of food. And this has been done by our ancestors for really long time, for hundreds and thousands of years. These has been practiced by our ancestors. It is just that it is called intermittent fasting by science, and science has done a lot of research on this, has been doing quite some research in past few years, but our ancestors have known the benefits of this tapasya, this intermittent fasting, for a long time, and they have been doing it. So you can do it from the perspective of tapasya, if not from the perspective of scientific intermittent fasting. I could have used the word tapasya in my videos instead of intermittent fasting, but it is a bodybuilding or come fitness channel. People would want to see it from the scientific way, so that is why I use the word intermittent fasting, but more or less it is equal to the tapasya that our ancestors used to do. Although in upvas you do not eat anything from the religious perspectives, from the tapasya perspective, but in upvas, from the scientific perspective, to make it easier, one can eat 200, 300, 500 or up to 600 calories for in that day, to make that day easier to go, because otherwise it becomes really hard to not eat for one day for the people who do not have practice on this. And fasting can be done for longer periods of time than 1 day or 2 days, but I haven't talked about this in these videos because it is a bodybuilding come fitness channel, and people in bodybuilding and fitness would not want to go for longer periods of fasting. There can be many other ways of fasting, but most famous are 16:8 when you're eating for your whole day, because it is not too tough to stay hungry for 16-hour window, and it is not too tough to eat all your food in an 8-hour window. So it is one of the most famous methods, and when you do not eat anything, then upvas is the most famous method, where basically you are not eating for your day, and you do that once or twice or thrice a week, or maybe alternate day fasting. So the intermittent fasting has been a part of many religions. So for example, in Muslims, they in the month of Ramzan, they would not eat in the daytime and they will eat in the night time. So that is kind of a variation of intermittent fasting. In Hindu religion and many other religions, they would not eat on some designated days like Puranmasi or Amavasya, and Karwa Chauth. On Karwa Chauth, the female would not eat the whole day, and she would eat at night. So there are designated days where you would not eat, so that is kind of intermittent fasting. And in Jains, I'm a Jain. So in Jains, we would not eat for the whole day or for a lot of days, keeping from the perspective of getting rid of bad karma from our soul. So people do it for really long time in Jains, for like a month. I think the longest I have heard for is about 120 or 142 days of fast continuous, just water, no food. So it is intermittent fasting is part of a lot of religions for really long time. If you like this video, please like, comment and share. I'll see you in the next video. Bye bye.